Hello everyone, this is a free online tutorial for the math section of the new SAT exam. This is problem number 10, section 3, found in the new SAT practice test 5. Okay, problem 10, section 3, no calculator section, practice test 5. If a squared plus b squared is equal to z and ab is equal to y, which of the following is equivalent to 4z plus 8y? So this is a problem asking for the correct use of substitution. So 4z plus 8y is equal to 4 times a squared plus b squared, because z is equal to a squared plus b squared. So 4z will be 4 times a squared plus b squared. And then ab is equal to y, so 8y, the product, 8 times y, will be 8 times ab, right? So 8ab. So now, when you distribute this and you combine it into a simpler form of three terms, you will have 4a squared plus 4b squared, because you apply the 4 to each of these terms. So you're going to have 4a squared plus 4b squared. Now, so when you combine everything, you will have 4a squared plus 8ab plus 4b squared. Now, you don't have to check all of these three terms with each answer choice. You can actually win time on this SAT exam should you have this kind of problem on the real SAT, on the actual test. You will just check the first term, because guess what? A, you see this, these two terms, when they're squared, that means you will have repeated this in a multiplication, right? So this will be multiplied by itself. So when you use the FOIL method, you will have two parentheses, right? A plus 2b and two of these parentheses. So you're going to have the first term as a times a, right? So a times a is a squared. Is a squared the same thing as 4a squared? No. So a is canceled out. You don't have to perform all of these steps to see whether three of these terms are the same. You will just check the first term of each of these answer choices against the first term that you found, which is 4a squared, right? So we just found that the first term for choice A does not match the first term that we just found of the expression here, right? So what about the second choice? 2a, when it's squared, 2a times 2a is going to be what? 4a squared. Bingo. There we go. Because the other choices have something completely different, because 4a times 4a is 16a squared. And same thing for choice B. For choice D. So 4a squared can only be produced with choice B, because when you have two parentheses, each parenthesis having 2a plus 2b, the first term using the FOIL method will be 2a times 2a, which is 4a squared, and that's the same thing here. And other choices do not produce the correct first term. Alright, so you can win time. The correct answer choice in this problem is B.